Hello and welcome back to RailRoads Online. So today we are taking delivery or delivering a new locomotive out to its destination out there at the logging camp. This is going to be our new log train, replacing one of the Climaxes at least for now. So we went ahead and picked up one of the new Class 70s. Through at number 606, woodchuck for Ant Inc. Timberline. Being it's really mainly going to be just for chucking wood out there at the log camp. So the other thing we have is that the new test porter has been moved over here somehow. We upon respawning up here today, we figured out that it's been moved. See if we can delete that track out of there. So now that's gone, so that should clean up our wonder if we were ever gonna be able to get Betty back out of here or not. So that takes care of that. We won't have to do much there. Gonna have to see if we can start using that rail again yet or not. Haven't checked on that just yet. I did figure as I was wrapping things up, I wanted to make sure that I went out and did replace that one Class 70 running the 16 log cars. I'm assuming this one will be able to do the trick out there, but you know, one never knows. Class 70 is pretty strong locomotive though, so I'm assuming it's gonna get the job done. Haven't run into too much this, especially where it's, you know, nothing is steep or anything out there, so it's gonna be doing it all on flat ground. Brakes off. Reverser forward. We do not have a... Oh, okay, the water level is rising, so it's pulling water from the tender now. Oh, we left the wood box door open. We'll straighten that out here in just a minute. I know we're gonna have to flip some rail coming up here. So there's that. So we'll jump out and straighten out the box then too. Ooh. All right, too much going on here. Let's let you, now that we can run so fast, we don't even have to worry about this, really. Flip that. This will have to go there. This one will have to get flipped there. So we can really start spacing out these switches instead of having them all on top of each other. Did that before because I don't like to run around back and forth. You know, when you're playing one player, it's just easier to have things closer together, I thought. But now that we can move around a little faster, we can space some of that stuff out. Looking forward to the new rail. Once we can start laying with some of that, it's going to let us do some different things and definitely have some smoother routes once it interacts with the trains. Just as far as I know, it does not interact with the trains yet. And now that I've been cleaning everything up, I haven't tried it yet, or tried it again for a couple of days. So maybe they changed something. I mean, that the test porter definitely moved. So I'm not exactly sure what else. I haven't read any kind of patch notes or anything for a few days. So at least a few days. So we'll just kind of see. All right. back to normal. All right. Oh. Close the fire. Right. Close the firebox. And here we go. Hit those. Turn off the brakes. Mash the gas. See what we get. That really is a good looking locomotive. It just looks a little stockier and beefier, if you will, than the old Class 70. So I am a fan of this one. It looks like a workhorse, so that's kind of cool. Digging that one. Speaking of cool, we did go over 100 subs on the channel this last week, so I wanted to say a big thank you to everybody there following the channel. Anybody who's not, if you can, like, share, subscribe, that kind of thing helps the channel grow, gets us out there. But we definitely do want to say thank you, and we appreciate all the people who have supported the channel, subscribing so far. It is awesome. So, big thank you there. And hopefully we keep on growing. Alright, turn our mist down. We got one more switch up here that, of course, potentially could be switched. So, of course, it will be switched. Not that we run out. Excuse me. We do not run out from the freight yard out to the logging camp a lot. I've thought about getting rid of this route, but then at the end of the day, it's like, you know, the one or two time you do need it, you get rid of it, and then you have a big pain trying to go around elsewhere. So it's like, I just am gonna leave it in there. You know, I'm sure plenty of rail companies out there, lines had a rail that, well, not often used. It gets used every once in a while. And so that's what this line is. Because really, you know, we never really go from the freight yard to the logging camp or back from the logging camp to the freight yard unless it's pretty much delivery of a new locomotive. The only time we use this, so. But, you know, you gotta have it. I guess that's the only reason we have a few pieces of track is for brand new locomotives coming out of the barn. But what are you gonna do? You gotta get them delivered somehow. Oops, that's not what we wanted. That's what we want. Should flip this one at least back, because this one we will never think about. This is all part of the layout, so we could have, you know, I don't know. It's set up so we can really run pretty much anywhere and be each. Industry runs its own independent loops pretty much, so despite a switch or two here or there, you can pretty much run, you know, any train on any loop at the same time any other train is running any other loop. You're not really going to run into a too much of a bind unless somebody's unloading, like maybe in certain places, I guess. But most of it, you can pretty much just run. You can run whatever, whenever, however you feel like it. This piece of track really does not get used often. This one goes back and forth mainly. We don't tend to use this often, so that's just the reel of how it works out. Alright, so the plan here is to kick this over and bring it down here. So, let's see if we can get you stopped by there. We certainly can kick that over. I don't know. I came up with, you know, you come up with these ideas for laying this track early, and if you don't change it, then you're like, but it works for, I don't know. Most of it just works. I don't have much of an issue doing things. So then I don't know, I haven't changed too much. Like at one point I was thinking we would have big trains sided out here. That's why these are, you know, big openings for train sidings is what they were really initially going to be. And I've never really had trains sided out here. So, you know, I don't know what the plan was back there. But then this will work for doing, you know, multiple things out here. Here is our train we are going to hopefully replace, or the locomotive. Uh-oh. Oop, stops on a dime when you throw it into reverse. I mean, with nothing on it, that's a nice thing. They really do stick quite well when you have nothing on them. It's all the weight of the rolling stock behind it that gets you to where you just can't stop. Alright, so then what we do not care for the fact that these are all backwards now. That's somewhat off-putting. Oop, alright, we have to unpin you, get all that stuff out of there. We will have to throw some wood. Oop. Don't know what's up with the floaty wood stuff or when that started. Never used to see that. Been seeing it more often lately. Just throwing that out there. I don't know about anybody else, but. Alright, forward, brakes. This is climax, so we're just gonna leave the brakes on. So you act more locomotive-like. Alright, that's fine. This we actually need to flip back this way. So we can send... Well, no we don't. Because I don't even know what we're going to do with this locomotive. So I guess for now, we will... We need to park it somewhere. Where to park it is the question. I guess probably not out here in the bush. So we will we will figure that one out. Jeez. In the burnout box somewhere. This thing just still blows my mind away. Uh-oh, we are gonna derail. No, we're not. You're like, do it, don't do it, do it, don't do it. I was really thinking I was just gonna slap this thing on a piece of rail off to the side out here, but I have now second-guessed myself right out of doing that. As in, I just don't see, I guess, the point in leaving it out here. If we're gonna put it somewhere, I'd rather put it at the freight yard. Where the rest of our trains have all gone to retire. Alright, now that one's out of the way. Of course, we have to bring that one. We need more room than that. Alright, we need more room than that. So just turn the brake off. The hyper beast is gonna have to move. Whoa! Absolute beast machine. Alright. We will flip you. Boom, boom, boom. That one's good. Run down here. Alright. This train should be, or a locomotive. Keep saying train. This locomotive, I'm figuring it'll be significantly easier to operate. And hopefully it'll do the job. I'm pretty sure it will. I can't imagine that the Climax really pulls. I mean, the numbers aren't that big a difference, so I'm thinking that the Climax doesn't probably actually pull that much more than the Class 70 does. And I would assume this Class 70 behaves very similar to the last one. My only question here is whether it's going to have the brakes to hold this big, long train. So, it's going to be Class 70 brakes, really, versus Climax brakes, more so than what pulls it. I don't think loading this train on this downhill grade here becomes a pain, because you get enough of it on the hill before it's loaded that it doesn't like to sit here. That's for sure. So, hopefully the Class 70 will do that, but I'm pretty sure it will. So we're going to slide it back into position here. Speaking of which, as we're backing up, whistle warning the people, but we need a link or we're going to back into nothing. I don't know. Thinking we might flatten this out here some, because it would make loading easier. Or set up a way so we really are loading in the other direction, maybe. I don't know. That would definitely be something we would do a little different, I think, in a rework. This all works out here, but, you know, it's the first stuff you do too, so the fact that it works, I guess, I'm pretty happy with. Alright, there we go. Good clicks, good clicks. That delivers that one for today and replaces the old Climax. So one more salute to the old Class, or not Class anything. The new Class 70, and out with the old Climax. Number 77 will be sent to other tasks or something somewhere else. But I think we'll call that one an episode. Remember, if you get a chance, then you can like, share, subscribe. Subscriptions are free, but they sure do help the channel. And we'll catch you on the next one.